Alright, hey there, this is the Shadow Ranger. I'm sick and I can't sleep. It's 3:39 a.m. and I'm bored, so I decided I'd make a video about something. I was thinking about something yesterday and I just want to throw it out to you. Looking at 2010 in the year of this year of pro wrestling, part of me is very satisfied with 2010 and part of me is disappointed. The side of me that is satisfied is just the fan, just the person who enjoys watching wrestling. That part of me is was very satisfied with 2010. I'm saying was because it's December 18th and I think pretty much everything important that is that's going to happen in 2010 has already happened. I doubt anything of real significance is going to happen within these last couple of weeks of 2010, so I'm going ahead and making this video now. The fan in me was satisfied. I was entertained, very much entertained, by the majority of what I saw in wrestling this year. I enjoyed the vast majority of what I saw from the WWE. I enjoyed the vast majority of what I saw from TNA. And I recently began watching NWA Championship Wrestling from Hollywood, and I've been thoroughly enjoying that too. The fan in me in 2010 has very few complaints. Overall, good year of wrestling, I was entertained. Nothing is going to stop me from watching wrestling every week in 2011. Excuse me. The side of me that's a little disappointed is the internet wrestling fan, the smark side of me who likes to analyze wrestling and break things down and discuss the business with other wrestling fans. And there's one main reason for that. Is even though I was thoroughly entertained by wrestling this year, I have to ask, what did wrestling accomplish in 2010? What was significant about 2010? What was really accomplished? I mean, you had some entertaining things, but there's really nothing long term. You introduced some new characters and you had some nice storylines, but there was nothing really big. I mean, the main goal of wrestling, it has to create new stars to keep itself going. You know, Shawn Michaels retired this year, and Triple H was gone most of the year. There's been a lot more talk about Undertaker winding his career down. So the wrestling business has always had to build and create new stars to keep people coming back. And that's an area where I think wrestling has failed this year. And when I say this, I'm talking specifically about WWE and TNA, the main two companies. How many stars were created in 2010? How many people, I mean, when you really think about it, how many people who were not stars on January 1st of 2010 are stars now? You know, some people will throw out The Miz, but he pretty much was made a star last year. He just got bigger this year. As I look through the wrestling landscape, I can only think of one person. Even with all the angles that went on in WWE and TNA and things that were done, I can only think of one person who came along in 2010 who I can say was not a star last year, but I would consider a star now. Like, somewhat of a draw. Like, people will either pay to see him win or pay to see him lose. And that's Wade Barrett. That's the only guy I look at. And maybe I'm forgetting somebody. If I am, throw somebody out. But he's the only person who stands out to me as this guy became a star in 2010. I mean, you have the rest of the members of Nexus, but does anybody consider them stars? I mean, most of them have just been Wade Barrett's lackeys. You had the season 2 rookies, and nobody's seen anything of them since season 2 ended, except for McGillicuddy and Harris joined Nexus, you know. Caval hasn't really done much, even though he won it. And where are the rest of the season 2 guys? I haven't seen Eli Cottonwood or Percy Watson, or I can't even remember the rest of the season 2 guys. Lucky Cannon? Where's Lucky Cannon? I don't, you know. Wade Barrett seems to be the only person who stands out that was made a star in 2010, and I don't think, and that's not a good thing. You can't just be building one star and expect to keep the business going. And then when you switch over to TNA, like I said, I thoroughly enjoyed a lot of what I watched in TNA this year, but how many stars did TNA make? I don't think they made anyone a star. A few guys got built up, but who wasn't a star on January 1st that you could call a star now? I mean, let's see. When I look at the landscape of TNA, the only person who I look at who I think got bigger, became more popular, was Jay Lethal. Just them taking him out of the Black Machismo gimmick and working with Ric Flair, and I think he became a bigger star than he already was. But I think he was already, but I don't think he got that much bigger. Like, it was starting to get things up with him, and it sort of petered out some for some reason. Like, they didn't keep up with it. And, you know, earlier this year, he's doing, amazing promo with Ric Flair and taking on AJ Slammiversary and making Flair tap to a figure four. And by the end of the year, he's feuding with Robbie E. And, you know, I like Robbie, but for Jay Lethal, that was a huge step down. So I'm going to stop it here because I'm about to start rambling. But, you know, let me know if there's someone I'm forgetting. Who was made a star in 2010? Who became a star in 2010? Who was not a star on January 1st of 2010, but you would say is a legitimate star in wrestling now? This is the Shadow Ranger. Thanks for listening. Bye.